I'll let you start out talking about the Coke.com and what's that all about?
Yeah, Coke is doing a new campaign and program where all the fans and supporters out there can go to coke.com/cheers and they can upload a picture of themselves along with like an encouraging letter or note to any Olympic athlete. And if they're chosen, then their picture and note will be put on a billboard in Times Square. So it's a really cool way for us to kind of connect with them and then support us and be a part of the whole journey.
So starting today, they can what? Log on and send a picture and say, Shawn, go, or just something simple like that, or
Yep, exactly. So later today it goes live and they can go on and do the note and the picture, and then evidently they're going to select many people, and it will just run on the Coke billboard and they can be a part of it with us.
and tell me about the graphic on there. That's actually you.
It is actually me. It's the new Coke packaging and it's really exciting. They put it on the can, they put it on the packaging. And it's my silhouette, just another way for them to support me and for me to, partner with their whole Olympic movement. It's an honor.
Does it have your name on there anywhere? Or people, Iowans will just get to know because of this interview that that's actually you.
It's kind of with their whole, packaging and their whole campaign through the commercials and everything. It'll be known, but it doesn't necessarily say Shawn Johnson on the packaging. It's just kind of, the known thing.
Are you going to be in the commercials as well?
I am. There'll be vignettes running. I mean, you'll see Coke everywhere, which is really cool because they're such a big part of it. So,
And is this like the biggest thing you've been involved in? I know you've done a lot of commercials and other kinds of things.
back in 2008, I was partnered with Coke as well when they did their big Coke 8-pack. So, this is my second time with them, and it was huge the first time, and it's probably be even bigger this one.
So do you want a lot of Iowans to log on today when they see
I
this?
do. I would love everybody to log on. Supporting Olympic athletes and being a part of it with us is what we kind of train and work for. We want to make them proud, and that's, competing for the people in the arena and the people watching is why we do what we do so well.
And speaking of training and working for, tell us where your training stands now.
Training's going well. Still taking it one day at a time. I have national championships coming up and Olympic trials, and trying not to get too overwhelmed with the fact that it's only 80 some days away, but just giving it what I have, and when the time comes, I'll be accepting of whatever I get. But I see the finish line, and it feels good.
So I didn't realize they push it right up, the trials go right up against almost the Olympics.
Yep,
So you don't
it
know to the
happened.
last minute.
No, but it happens that way every 4 years. Gymnastics is one of the last sports to be picked, just because of how I don't know. How much our sport changes on a daily basis, with injury and with everything. They want to make sure that the team they pick is the right one. And so July 1st is when our team is announced, and I think we leave like July 13th. So
And speaking of injury, how is your knee?
my knee's doing pretty well. I have good days and bad days. It's stronger than it's ever been, since the injury. So it's getting better and better every day. But still working through it, still doing some rehab, still trying to, make it even stronger than before.
And what's the most challenging part for you this time around?
I'd say the most challenging part is just knowing what's coming. I think the first time I had that advantage of just being so naive that I was taking on the world and had no idea what was coming. But this time it's intimidating. I know how long the process is. I know how grueling and how, mentally and physically demanding it is. So it scares me, it terrifies me, but it's also extremely exciting because I know what the end result will bring.
Is it almost as if you can't think about it too much? You just have to let your body do what it knows how to do?
Exactly. I think that's a hard part for me this time around is I'm thinking about everything. I know too much almost. So my mind gets, wrapped up in everything. But when I just kind of put that aside and train and take it one day at a time, then it comes easier and more naturally.
And are you focusing this time around again on the balance beam, or will you be in other events, or focusing on getting ready for other events?
Focusing on all around beam is definitely my specialty and my strongest, but this time with only 5 spots available, it's just about fitting a certain puzzle piece. I'm not sure where I'll fit in yet or if I'll fit in, but it's just about kind of rearranging things on, a month-to-month basis, trying to make sure, you know, in July, I fit one spot.
Will you go either way?
I would love to. I mean, you know, I hope to say that I'll be on the team and going to London, but, you know, you have to be realistic in knowing that the other might happen. And I would love to go no matter what, support my teammates. I mean, they're my family. They're like my sisters. So I couldn't see myself not going over there and screaming my head off for them.
Mm-hmm. And are you working with Chow in a different way now? I mean, are you out there every single day, or what is your schedule like?
My schedule's kind of dependent on how I'm feeling, how my body's reacting. I mean, it's a whole new ballpark this time around. My body decides one day that it just can't do anything and I need a break, and the other day I can push, you know, or the other times I can push 16 days in a row without stopping. It's just, you know, how where I am in training. But working with Chow is definitely different. It's more, you know, of a two-person thing anymore, and we're kind of equals instead of, you know, just coach and athlete. I have a lot more say, which is really cool. It means a lot more to me this time around, and it's really cool for him to see how much I've grown up in the past 4 years.
Mm-hmm. And you really feel like you have, especially with your attitude going into it this time.
I think so. You know, I was the baby the first time around, and this time I'm kind of like the veteran and the mama of the group, and having a leadership role instead of like the underdog is different, but I love it. I feel like I can help the girls out, and taking on kind of a mentor position and just kind of helping them through everything.
Is there an average age for
16.
Oh, it is 16.
Yep. Most girls, I mean, 90% of the girls are 16 at the Olympics. So the younger you are, you know, the more energy, the more power, the more, you know, just listen and be told and do kind of mentality they have. And they can last longer. I mean, that's the ripe age for the sport.
Mm-hmm. And tell me about, we talked about the other night, about some of the things that you hope to do in the future. You were talking about maybe just going over to Africa or things like that.
Philanthropy work is something I'm really interested in. Afterwards, you know, I would love to hopefully work with UNICEF or charitable foundations, anything. You know, I feel like I've been wrapped up in the business side of things for so long. I want to be able to kind of give it back now. And I've never really had the time to do that. So I think it would be a great experience, and being able to help out people would be something I'm very interested in.
And you're interested in working overseas?
Yeah, if I could. You know, I feel like there's so many different places around the world that, you know, need our help and can, I don't know, give me a new experience, a new outlook on everything. And overseas, I think, would be an experience of a lifetime.
And just looking back, some of the things that you've done over the last couple of years and how you've spent your time.
I've done a ton of things over the past few years. I've spent a lot of time, again, with charitable foundations. I do a lot with Make-A-Wish, Ronald McDonald House Charities. I did a big fundraiser for Leukemia Lymphoma Society. And I don't know, anything I can kind of help out with. But I've also done a lot of things like the tour of Gymnastic Superstars and Dancing with the Stars, of course. Just everything. I've seemed to stay pretty busy, but I love that.
So you've lived the dream the last 4 years already.
I guess you could say that, yeah. It's been a whirlwind, but I love it, and I hope I can continue to live it for a while.
Okay.